Good morning. I didn't sleep very well last night. And when you don't sleep well, you know what happens? You express with your face, you stress out, you make expressions while you're sleeping, and you make your wrinkles on your forehead deeper as a result. But fortunately, I did put my facial patches on last night. And you know, I don't wear them every night because some nights I just hop in bed and I'm not worried about it. But the more expressive I am during the day, the more these little lines start to show up. And then, of course, I certainly wear them. Actually, I've worn them for a long time. So I usually wear them maybe 3 nights a week in a row, consecutive nights, because that was what makes a difference for the muscle. But I want to show you this morning my favorite way of applying the patch. So we have the patches that are in a rectangle shape and they're perforated so you can tear them. I don't know if you can see. Yeah, you can see the perforations on the back of there, right? So I've torn this piece out that looks like a little butterfly wing. And because of the shape of my face, and that's the deal, it's the shape of everybody's face that you apply them differently. So I wet the back with the rose water hydrator spray. Make sure sometimes people ask, how do you make sure it's sticky? Well, I kind of just automatically, without thinking about it, move my finger around on the back of it. So I've activated all the adhesive. Now, because of the shape of my eyebrows and what I do with my face, this really works well for me to put this little point right here and to curve this around my eyebrow. Now, on the box, it says these are for the corners of your eyes and the corners of your mouth, but you can use them anywhere on the face where the muscle and the skin are attached. And that's why they work, because the muscle and the skin on the face are attached. So see, I took the one, we normally say these go here. And they can. I'll show you that another time. But I like to overlap these and bring this really narrow point down between my brows. And so I've overlapped them so it's even getting heavier, and that's where I get the crease. If you're going to overlap anything, you overlap it where you get the crease, because that's what you want to build. So the thing about Frownies is that they're actually tailorable. You can tailor them to fit your face. So here's the piece that normally goes on the outside corner of the eye. I'm going to fill this little gap in right here, and this is how I like to wear my patch. It covers my horizontal lines I get from lifting my brow, which I really can't do very well because I've just now isolated all the muscles. That's the point with Frownies. If you want to know if your facial patches are actually effective, put them on and try to move your face. If you can move your face, they're not really working. They might be helping the surface of the skin, but so does any moisturizer or cream that's good, and we'll talk about that in another video as well. But they're not changing the shape of the muscle underneath if you can move your face once you put them on. Now, I'll be able to lift, but I can't move under the patch. So if your lines are really wide on the side of the face, then I would just take another little piece and place it over top of this area. The other thing that's really beneficial because about tailoring your patches is we all have a different shaped forehead. Some people have a forehead that kind of just goes straight up. Other have the real round forehead. Wrinkles occur on different areas of the face. So with these, you can tailor it to fit. People have asked, why don't you just make one huge patch that fits on the face? Well, I'm working on redesign and creating new patches all the time. And I'm working on material and looking at what would be a good material. And the thing about one flat, stiff patch is, for my forehead, it buckles either at the top or at the bottom. But with building my patch, I've built a tailor-made custom splint. So my muscles, and I can feel it now. See, like if you've seen other videos of me, I raise my eyebrows. When I talk, I do a lot of facial expressions, but I can't do it. You can see a little bit of movement, but my whole forehead moves as one piece because the muscles are strong. They're strong because I've not broken them down with chemicals or injections or fillers, because if you do that, that weakens the muscle, right? So, question I've had about the patches that I want to address too is, if you're using retinol, can you use a patch over it? I don't know what retinol does to every person's skin. Some people, it makes their skin really thin and fragile and sensitive. So you have to answer that question by treading very lightly if you're using a chemical treatment. You can try it. But when you remove the patch, the best way to remove your patch is to, I leave it on in the shower. I get up in the morning, I hop in the shower, and it gets thoroughly soaked, and then it just slips right off. Like the last video, I showed you I was all sweaty in the morning. I had the patch on, and I could pull it right off because it was wet underneath the patch. How do you get it wet underneath? Well, you can sweat it off, or you can soak it off. This is my favorite application of forehead patches. There are other ways to do it, and share yours. Thanks.